Hey, welcome back to the Crowdfunding Demystified YouTube channel. My name is Salvador Brigman, and here we talk about crowdfunding, raising money online using Kickstarter, Indiegogo, GoFundMe, and charity fundraising, and also for nonprofits. And today I want to talk about using Instagram on GoFundMe, and specifically, how do you add your GoFundMe link to your Instagram story? This is a question that I've been getting more as Instagram becomes more popular. We have, I think, people aging up, you know, from 30s, 40s, 50s using Instagram. My mom uses Instagram now. And I want to talk a little bit about how you can use Instagram stories to actually promote your ongoing GoFundMe campaign. So first of all, let's just get to the brass tacks of it. And I have to warn you that a lot of the times Instagram is changing their algorithm, they're changing their functionality. So make sure that you check my fact finding, if you will, on this video, because this might be, you might be watching this, you know, a year down the road. Make sure that what I'm saying is also still applicable today. But at the time I'm recording this video, you can only embed a link in your Instagram story under two cases. The first is if you have a verified account. A verified account usually are people who are celebrities or influencers, individuals who have noteworthy credibility in society. It doesn't necessarily correlate with your follower count. It could be you could have 5,000 followers and you could have a verified account. So it doesn't matter, but you need to either have a verified account on Instagram to embed a link in your Instagram story, or you have to have more than 10,000 followers and have a business account. It's really easy to have a business account on Instagram. I have a Instagram account for this YouTube channel under Crowdcrux, which you can check out some of the videos that I have on there. They're like short 1 minute videos that kind of go into crowdfunding tips, but you need a business account. And that's just really a very simple process of transitioning your personal account over to your business account. But the stickler here is that you need at least 10,000 followers in order to be able to use a link in your Instagram story in order to, for people to go and check it out and say, you know, if you ever watch Instagram stories and they're like, hey, swipe up if you want to check out this thing. If you want to say, swipe up to donate to my GoFundMe campaign, the only way you'd be able to do that is under these two conditions. So if you don't meet those conditions, then that might be a little bit of a sticking point for you. If you do not meet these conditions, what can you do? Basically, what are your options? Well, I have another video out there on YouTube talking about how do you use Instagram in combination with your GoFundMe campaign. I also have a book out there called Crowdfunding Personal Expenses, which goes into how to raise money for personal expenses using GoFundMe and more strategies and tips for using social media in order to get backers and people to donate to your campaign, even if they're strangers and you don't know them necessarily, they're not in your social network. One of the other things that you could do would be to network with other influencers. So just because you don't have a verified account or you don't have 10,000 followers or business account doesn't mean that other people don't. So you could also form relationships with people that have a business account, that have a bunch of followers on Instagram, and ask them to share your story and to try and make an elevator pitch. You know, elevator pitch is kind of just like a very succinct pitch compressing everything that you're trying to say in your GoFundMe campaign into just a couple of sentences or into just something very short that they could tease on their Instagram story and approach some influencers and ask them, would they be willing to help you out and to share this on their Instagram profile? So that's another thing that you could do. But besides that, honestly, I would recommend diving into that other video that I got on how to use Instagram, and also to check out some of the other videos like on this channel on ways to creatively promote your charity or fundraising campaign. And also, I have some other content out there, which I'll try and include as a link in the description of this YouTube video. But if you have any more questions, leave a comment on this video, because my name is Salvador Brigman. I love answering your questions. Give me a thumbs up if you did like this video. Come subscribe if you want more content like this, and I will see you next time.